The Orbital Mining Corporation, or OMC for short, is a small space technology startup located in Golden, Colorado. Ken Liang and Chris Tolton, both graduates of the Colorado School of Mines where they met, teamed up to found Orbital Mining Corporation, a space technology startup focused on lunar power and mining. Liang and Tolton, while studying for their MS in space resources, quickly discovered they had similar interests in both the space resources industry and entrepreneurship. They also had complementary talents and backgrounds. Chris has the big idea and solid plan of what to do as CEO, and I thought that would be great to pair with my engineering expertise, Liang said. Then we soon found out about what's on the moon, about 2 or 3 weeks before the application was due. It was fortunate we met when we did. They've already won $600,000 in funding for getting into the finals, and they recently won second place in the finals, which resulted in another $500,000 from NASA. Mining is power intensive, Liang said. If you're going to mine the moon, you're going to need a stable power plant. Ultimately, that's what we're looking to do, and we think we can get there by the end of the decade. P3, Power, Prospecting and Propellant. OMC's objective is to build the first lunar power plant and direct current microgrid. At the same time, map the distribution of useful materials on the moon's surface. Examples of useful materials would be water ice and carbon deposits, which are believed to have come from the impacts of carbon-rich asteroids. Many useful materials are likely to be found on the moon's surface. This is because the moon has been subject to massive bombardment from asteroids for millions of years. Since there is no weathering or tectonic movement on the moon, all these materials, including rare earth minerals, platinum group metals, and more, are right there on the surface, untouched, at far greater ore density than can be found on Earth. Once a power grid of sufficient size has been established and useful materials prospected, the next and final step is mining. Production of propellant and other materials is essential to enable long-term settlement of the moon and expand operations in cislunar space. This is because the moon's gravity is only 1/6 of the Earth, so lifting materials into cislunar space is much easier than from the Earth's large gravity well. Initially, OMC wants to mine water ice, carbon dioxide and oxygen. Why those materials? Well, water can be used for producing rocket fuel through electrolysis, powering fuel cells, providing breathable oxygen, and supplying water necessary for drinking, agriculture, and various other applications. Carbon dioxide is useful for plant growth and can be converted into organic compounds for food or methane used as rocket propellant. Both the Super Heavy launchers chosen by NASA needed to land astronauts on the moon use methane as a propellant. Starship uses methane exclusively, and Blue Origin uses it for the launcher, while the lander is powered by hydrogen. Okay, let's look at the technology OMC is using. OMC is focused on building electrical power grids on the moon through the development of a DC to DC converter system. This system is designed to endure the harsh lunar environment, including the extreme temperature fluctuations encountered during the lunar day and night, each of which lasts for about 2 weeks. During the lunar day, systems must cope with temperatures as high as 127 degrees Celsius. That's 260 degrees Fahrenheit, requiring efficient cooling solutions. On the other hand, during the extended lunar night, the temperature drops dramatically to about minus 173 degrees Celsius. That's minus 280 degrees Fahrenheit, presenting the significant challenge of keeping systems warm enough to function. This dual requirement makes the design and operation of power systems on the moon particularly complex. The company is employing a 2-kilowatt step-up converter designed to operate over an ultra-wide temperature range, ensuring high reliability and efficient power generation. This converter system is lightweight, at just 2 kilos, that's 4.4 pounds, and affordable, costing only $8,000 for a set of two. One of the features of this system is its scalability. Multiple units can be used in parallel, making it straightforward to increase power output as needed. Why use a DC to DC converter system on the moon? A DC to DC converter is an electric circuit or device that converts a source of direct current, that's DC, from one voltage level to another. It's a type of power converter. These types of systems have very high efficiency, typically over 90%. Lunar habitats and mining outposts will likely have a mix of power sources, like solar panels, fuel cells, battery storage, and even nuclear. A DC to DC converter is essential in managing these power systems efficiently. They can convert the variable power from a solar panel or the slowly decaying power from battery storage to stable voltage needed for operating electrical equipment. Different equipment on the moon will need different voltages. A DC to DC converter can step up or step down the voltage as needed. This means all equipment can get the necessary voltage without them all needing a separate power source for each voltage requirement. Grid stability is boosted as the system can reroute power if one power source fails, perhaps by sending power from battery storage instead. These systems can be easily scalable as new power sources are added to the grid. Power optimization is important on the moon, where every watt matters. Extra power that isn't needed can be rerouted to battery storage so nothing is wasted. Especially considering lunar nights last for 2 weeks and equipment needs to be kept warm to avoid freezing. Upcoming events. Orbital Mining Corporation has a roadmap going from today up to 2030. Let's look at it briefly to see how they plan to scale their ideas into a fully operational power grid on the moon. This year, that's 2024, they will demonstrate a 200 watt converter here on Earth. In the following 2 years, that's 2025 to 2026, they plan on launching a cryogenic cold startup from a 2 kilowatt high voltage direct current converter. Following in 2026 and 2027, they will work on the hardware interface for a future lunar electrical grid. Finally, by 2030, they anticipate being able to supply an electrical grid to support lunar mining operations on the moon. We're keeping tabs on this company as constructing dependable systems from the moon is incredibly challenging due to the severe conditions, which include intense radiation, extreme cold during the lunar night, a hard vacuum, and the notorious sticky abrasive lunar dust. Be sure to subscribe to get the latest news on commercial space startups around the globe, from rocket launches to space stations, orbital tugs, lunar landers and more. If it's a commercial space startup, we cover it. See you soon.